cut yesterday's video a little short. Well, I say short, it was 39 minutes long, but when we came to do the second part that I told you we would be right back, when we tried to do the second part, the batteries weren't, they were too low that the camera wouldn't start up and let us film another clip. So we stuck to, we took the data off the camera. I've got that video uploading, should be able to see it. In fact, you'll probably, by the time you see this, you will probably have already watched it. But it's processing now, and we are on to part two. Now this little guy, 5 pound, this little 5 pound guy, he is right about 3.5 months. No, I take that back, he's 3 months old. This is, and you know, again, some of you that don't follow our videos, if you're just tuning in, you may not know her. His mother was Zoe. She was our one-eyed buck, or one-eyed doe. One-eyed buck. Yeah. Anyway, she was our one-eyed doe. She has gone to a new home. In anticipation of some youngsters that we were having, that were growing for. To be breeding stock for the latter part of this year, well, we had to start making room for them, you know, out with the old in with the new kind of thing, you know, and Zoe went to a very good home, and she is well looked after. This is her child. This is the one that we have. This is the one that we have left.
The only one.
This was the only one that we had out of Zoe while she was here. She was only with us a few months. And she did miss a time or two. But this is, he doesn't have a name. He's not going to be staying with us. He is looking for somebody that would like to put him to work or take him to the show. But he's a pretty nice buck. If you're in the region and looking for a buck or looking for a rabbit to show this spring, he is a good prospect, I just want to say. But he's not going to be sticking around. I just wanted to show you this is how some of our youngsters have grown up. So I'll put him back. And a lot of these rabbits here, these guys, this nothing's changed. All these guys you've met, that's Pepper, Mouse, you know Smitty, and you know Witter. Now we come over here, that's Jasmine. You've met Jasmine. This is Annabelle. You've met Annabelle. These two critters right here you have not met. These are, they haven't received a name, and I'm not even certain that they will be staying with us, but we are looking at them for possible show prospects. We're not prepared to go to any shows yet, even though there are shows happening in different parts of the country already in January. Okay, there we got it. Now,
tell me, buddy.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, you got touched. Yep, these little guys are somewhat excitable. Okay, come on, no, come here, you. Rascal, yeah. This is the son of Romeo and Sangria. Remember, Sangria had a litter of four. One of those bucks has gone to a new home. The doe that she had has gone to a new home, and these two bucks are what we have left, and they are being looked at as possible show entries coming up in March and April. This one is a little bit, I think this one might be a little bit bigger, but it's a little lighter in color. Of course, color being the last thing that you want to worry about, but I have seen rabbits, I have seen New Zealand Reds lose on color. and what have you. So, all other things being equal, probably not this guy, but the other guy here, because we're only going to show one junior doe, one junior buck. Anything other than that, and you're really shooting yourself in the foot, because all your rabbits are just competing against each other. I don't have to take them anywhere to do that. I want to see how they stack up against others in the area. That's my opinion. Of course, a lot of times the judge's opinion can be a valuable thing. So sometimes there's something to be said for taking three or four or five juniors in there and just letting the judge, getting the judge's opinion on them. Letting the judge's comments help you decide on which ones you want to show. Okay. He doesn't have a name either, but if you'll notice, he's brother to that one. Also, Romeo and Sangria. This is probably going to be my pick for a buck. Okay? Probably. I like his color. He's growing out pretty nice. He's got a pretty nice top line. He's still growing. We're still looking at him. We don't have to make a decision until about 3 days or 4 days before a show. So, we're still looking at him. As long as he's still here, he's still a prospect. So, well, for us anyway, even if he leaves, he's still a prospect. It would just be somebody else's decision.
Okay. Mustang Sally.
You know Mustang Sally. A little slippery there. Mustang Sally is hopefully expecting a litter on the 15th of February. Here's Sally. Are you about to get me? Rascal. Anyway, she is, and I don't know, I just know in my heart this is going to be the one. If you'll notice, I think the last time you saw her on video, she was living right here. She's moved over here. Sangria used to reside right here. Sangria, we took her in. She was due on the 23rd of February. She was due to kindle a litter.
January.
What did I say? February? Okay, yeah, January. January 23rd, she was due to kindle a litter, so we took her in a couple days prior to that. And we let Sally have, when we took her out, Morgan was already here, I think, or maybe not. Anyway, we just moved Sally over here, and Sally has showed an interest for the first time in using a drop-down nest box, so hopefully that'll work out. I knew every doe that we've had prior to her has used one and would use one, so we were hoping it was just a matter of time. Anyway, we took Sangria in 2 days before she was due to kindle, and on the afternoon of the 22nd, Sangria passed away. I got up that morning and I knew she was kind of acting a little off, but just like anybody would, knowing that she was pregnant and close to her due date, I just assumed that it was early labor. And didn't think a whole lot about it. And that afternoon, about 3 p.m., she was gone. I'm not going to go into detail, folks, here, and don't ask me how I know. But what had happened is, evidently her kits had died inside her. Yes, this can happen. And she did not abort those kits. And I forget what the term for it is, but it's a sickness that a doe can get when they have kits to die inside them. People can get it if they have a baby to die. A lady can have a baby to die, and if it's not aborted or removed, the process of that decay causes a mother to get sick and die. Evidently, that's what happened to Sangria. Again, don't ask me how I know this, but I had to know. So, Sangria is no longer with us, and that's all I have to say about that. We move over here. This is, you guys have met Morgan. Morgan was around on the side there, but when we moved Sally, this cage was sitting here empty, and she didn't need a nest box. So we put Jasmine around there, and we moved her and her two youngsters up here. Now, she had a litter of five, and has two left. She had the little Charlie. I don't remember if I showed you the little Charlie. I know I posted pictures of it on the Facebook fan page. If you guys haven't liked or followed that fan page, hey, it's pretty neat. I try to keep an up-to-date, you know, day-to-day little blog like going on that page and let people know in somewhat real time what's actually going on around here. And if you're interested in that sort of thing, well, jump over there. It's Hillbilly Half Acre Homestead. Now, there's a group. We don't update the group, okay? That group actually needs to be deleted or something because, I mean, we don't update it, and we still have people that are requesting to join even though we don't update it. So we really need to update that or delete that. But the fan page, we update almost daily in some manner, some little update of some sort of what's going on around here. And if you're into that sort of thing, we'd love to have you. Come over there and share pictures of your bunnies and tell us what's going on. You know, it's not just for us to post. We like for others to post. Not a lot of people posting on there right now, but it's going to pick up. Anyway, one of these little youngsters, and they, one of these little youngsters is sold. Hi. This is a lilac otter. This is the two that Morgan ended up with. She had, the little Charlie, and she had two brokens. One of the brokens died at birth or shortly after. I thought it was a peanut. I think it's a peanut. The other two, I don't know. The Charlie, or the little broken, passed away. And then I don't know. 3 or 4 days later, the little Charlie passed away as well. So
I re-looked at that one, and it's a doe. So we got two does in there.
Okay. Well, one of them is sold.
Yeah, and her name's Sterling.
Yep. One of these, and they look just alike. They're almost perfect twins. But one of these is the name is going to be Sterling, and it is sold. It is going to go to her forever home as soon as she is of age. In fact, I've got to look at my software or my computer where I keep all this stuff down, because I can't keep it all straight in my head. But somewhere around 5-6 weeks, we're going to start weaning them, because if it was successful, Morgan is already rebred. We went ahead and she hasn't lost an ounce of weight, and she's only got the two kits, so we went ahead and let her rebreed. And she did rebreed. Sometimes, though, I find that if the doe still has kits and I go ahead and rebreed them while she still has kits, a lot of times she'll breed, but she won't become pregnant. In other words, she won't release eggs to be fertilized. Even though everything looks like a successful breeding, she won't actually release eggs inside herself to be fertilized and become little baby bunnies. So, and a lot of times that has to do with the fact that they're stressed because they have all the bunnies, you know, pulling them down, trying to nurse on them and everything, and running them around in circles, because once these little guys can get out of these nest boxes, they'll run the doe ragged in circles all day long, trying to get her, turn on her back and slide up under her to nurse. And a lot of times, I think that's more the reason why the does lose weight than the actual nursing. They have to keep moving. They get a lot of extra activity from running around in circles trying to avoid hungry babies. But once they get big enough and they learn to drink out of the automatic waterers, or they drink out of the, then it seems like they are a little better. But from the time they get out of the nest box till about three and a half, 4 weeks, they can run a doe just ragged. But she's doing okay with just the two, so we went ahead and let her rebreed. And so we want to get her, get these off of her within the next week or so, so that she can have time alone to rest and recuperate and what have you before time to start all over again. Okay, and then again, that's Morgan. That's her babies. They're doing well. Just love them. Just love how they're doing, how they've turned out. Excuse me. Now, these two little ladies I've had since Christmas. And you haven't seen them yet. Unless you like my Facebook page. If you like my Facebook page, you saw them a few days after they came home. They were sitting on the couch watching TV with me. We were eating, they were trying to get my macaroni and cheese, the little rascals. One was sitting on the back of the couch trying to come up over my shoulder and get in my plate, and the other one was down here by my knee where I was sitting on the end of the couch trying to get in my plate. So anyway, they're out here now, so my mac and cheese is safe now. And oh, be nice. This is we can tell them now the way they're laying here. This is Bianca. Bianca's the smaller of the two. These young ladies are not, ouch. Okay, let's do this a different way. We'll do it your way then. See, I didn't want to do that. Okay, come on. See, you came out of there anyway, didn't you? This is Bianca. Both of these ladies, they are sisters. They are from Northern Ohio Rabbitry. Northern Ohio isn't actually in Ohio. That's a long story, but look up Northern Ohio Rabbitry on the internet and you'll see what I'm talking about. He's got a Facebook page or group or what have you, and you can check that all out. I'll let you contact him if you want to hear the story. But this is Bianca. She is the daughter of Chug Hole Sorrel 96 and Grace Hollow's Marcy. And Marcy is the daughter of Harmony. And I'm not even going to say, because I can't remember and I'll probably say it wrong, because there's just too many rabbits come out of that rabbitry for me to try to remember them all. That's what pedigrees are for, folks. Anyway, real proud of her. Hopefully she is going to be a nice mama and a nice and what have you. But just tickled to death to have them here. This is going to be part of our red line for, but they more than likely, just going by their ages now, they more than likely won't be breeding before the summer break. They are a little bit upset. These ladies have, it's about that time. We caught them kind of fighting yesterday. But I had the buck that I showed you first in this video, the red one over there, I had him in here. And I thought because he was in here and he was starting to sniff around on them, I thought he had them upset and maybe that was why they were fighting. So I removed him. I'm hoping they'll calm down because they can live together in here for a little while yet before they get too big. But if not, we'll just go ahead and get another cage hooked up somewhere somehow and get them separated. But this is Cheyenne. She too, like I said, Northern Ohio Rabbitry. That is actually in Mark Tree, Arkansas, by the way. I didn't say that. I started to say it with Bianca. Northern Ohio Rabbitry is actually in Mark Tree. And my exact question to the man was, how do you end up with a Northern Ohio Rabbitry in Mark Tree, Arkansas? And I got my answer. I'm not going to go into it. I'll let him take care of that. You can contact him. You can find Northern Ohio Rabbitry on Facebook. And just ask him about that, because he loves to tell the story. But this is Cheyenne. She, ouch, 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 ouch. Well, yep, we haven't got them tame. And that, and I think they're upset because of either because they're still together. Here, I'll just let her go back in there. But that's Cheyenne. She's going to be a nice big lady. Now, Bianca at this point is a little bit smaller. Okay, not gonna stress it. We do have another young lady, another red, that's hopefully, Lord willing, and the creeks don't rise, this coming Saturday. Yeah, we will take some video, hopefully. We're making another trek across the state of Arkansas to beautiful Grace Hollow Rabbitry and Homestead. And we're going to bring home a couple of bunnies. And if you can contact, if you're in the northeast Arkansas area and you would like to have a rabbit transported back from Grace Hollow Rabbitry, she's got some rabbits for sale, I believe. Contact her. Make arrangements with her to purchase that rabbit and we'll bring it back for you because we're going next Saturday. This video is being filmed on a Tuesday and I hope I can have this up sometime later today or tomorrow. So you'll have to act quick. But if you need a rabbit transported back to northeast Arkansas, or more specifically, we live in the Piggott area, but we're going to be coming through Jonesboro, Pocahontas, places like that, Corning. So if you want a rabbit transported back, now we're going on Saturday, February the 4th. So you got to get things done and let me know before then because I got to be able to take enough carriers along. I'm just throwing that out there. PJ's a friend of mine. I love to help out everybody, but PJ's a friend of mine, and I'd love to see more of her rabbits in this part of the country. I mean, you know, there's nothing wrong with the ones that are here, but this is like anyway. That's by Bianca and Cheyenne. I've got a couple more coming, like I said, that I'm gonna pick up next Saturday. I'm not gonna tell you a whole lot about them. Some of you people have this inquisitive way of finding out things without me actually telling you. More specifically, you see my post on Grace Hollow's Facebook page and you realize that I just picked up certain rabbits and am planning to go pick them up. I won't mention any names, Wendy. Anyway, but that's all I'm going to say in a video because we're going to make another video after they get here, okay? Because I am just tickled to death with what they are and what they are going to be and where they are going to be and what.
And I am tickled to death. Whose parents are.
Yeah, and one of them, well, actually both. Actually both. Tickled to death with who their parents are and what have you. Both of these rabbits, at one point in time, I have inquired about trying to purchase their one of their parents. And, well, you know, PJ, wise as she is, she don't, you know, she knows she wanted to, she knew she wanted to hang on to the parents, so she gave me the opportunity to grab a hold of the best of their children and can't wait to show those to you. Anyway, that's enough about that. Let's move on around. I don't remember, folks, if I have ever... Ouch! I do that every time I come around this cave. I don't remember if I have ever shown you properly blueberry. But just to make sure, we're going to do that now. Because looky here, he's molted all that old nasty fur out. Actually, I did show you. He had nasty fur, I remember. Looky here. What a gorgeous buddy. Looky here, he's molted all that old nasty fur out. If it wasn't for the fact that I think he's going to be just a tad heavy, I might try to show him in the spring as a senior, but he's going to be, I believe, a tad heavy. I haven't had him on the scales, but he feels a little hefty.
Yeah.
But that's not his fault. As many of you more negative commenters have been quick to point out, there's a lot of fat people that live here, and I guess us being fat, we like to eat. We like to make sure that our rabbits eat, and sometimes we make sure that they eat a little too much. But hey, just like with any other animal, an animal with a full belly is a happy animal, and I want a happy animal. So get back in there, little buddy. He just as sweet as can be. I just love that little rabbit. Smitty. Okay, I told you about Smitty yesterday. We'll move on down the line here. I'm not going to pull him out, but here's Romeo. And here's Sawguy. Here's Sawguy, big guy. We almost, on a couple of occasions, finally had some youngsters out of him. The good news is if Annabella's pregnant, they belong to Sawguy. So if we can get something successful to happen there, we will have some youngsters out of Sawguy. Annabelle right now is the only red that I've got left that can produce. So, you know, we sold Zoe with anticipation of these youngsters coming up and eating the cage space, and then how do you anticipate something like what happened with Sangria? You just can't. So it set us back a little bit for this part of the year on New Zealand's. But if anything holds true like what it has in the past, usually when we suffer some setbacks, things usually, you know, just by the grace of God, things usually bounce back and are actually better than they were before the setback. So we'll see if that happens. I have faith, and I know God can make it happen, and if he so chooses, he certainly will. Now this little guy here is somewhat skittish, and I have spooked him on one occasion and he bit me. Come here, buddy. But I love him anyway. This is Tagalong. He has been with us for, I don't know, 2 or 3 weeks, a month, something like that. I can't remember. I think he's been here almost a month. Well, if you can't tell on the camera, he's a mini Rex. He's a solid black. No otter. See, no otter pattern. He's a solid black. He is just a gorgeous rascal. And this is our new black herd buck. He is taking the place of Smitty, or Blacksmith, as you've heard me call him. Blacksmith. Or I prefer to call him Smitty. Smitty is for sale and going to go to a new home. And nothing wrong, okay? It's not always when a rabbit breeder gets rid of an older rabbit, it doesn't always mean there's something wrong with that rabbit. But if you're going to breed for show, as a matter of continuous improvement, you have to be constantly raising up youngsters to make breeders out of them. And in order to do that, to make room, you have to move the old ones out. Let somebody else benefit from those. You know, people starting out a herd, a lot of times you can sell them a nice breeder or a nice breeding pair and get them a little jump start on what their project, what they're wanting to do with the rabbits, and at the same time make room for yourself and to raise up your youngsters. But Tagalong has got, see this gorgeous, I don't know, Dan, is this showing up? Is it focusing? See this gorgeous fur? He's just got gorgeous fur. He's got short little old fur. He's got short little, no, don't you bite me. He's got short little old thick fur ears here. Hey, cool it. Look at them thick ears, thick furry ears. That's one thing that had been lacking. Of course, I mean, it's not just a huge fault. Ears, I think, may be worth 5 points. Don't quote me on that. I'm not certain. But Tagalong's molting a little bit. See, he's got some nasty fur he needs to molt out here. And this could be from spraying. He could have been spraying. They've got the stainless steel partitions in between here. That don't stop them from spraying. It just stops them from spraying each other. In other words, Tag can't spray Sawguy. Sawguy can't spray Tag. Neither one of them can spray the wall and end up getting themselves in the process. Bucks. Not all bucks are the same, but some bucks can be as nasty as an old tomcat about spraying urine all over the place. And it's just, I prefer to have bucks that don't do that, but they're all going to do it to some degree. Just remember, if you're showing, don't put your show bunny next to a buck without having a partition in between. I mean, if you've got a doe or a junior buck that's not spraying yet, don't put it next to a senior buck because they're going to hose him down. That is a fact. And just something to think about. And you don't put a white rabbit, I don't care what it is, you don't put a white rabbit within 6 feet of a buck because that thing is going to turn yellow. And there ain't nothing more embarrassing than trying to take a white bunny or a yellow bunny to a white rabbit show. Oh, I ran into that. I thought winter was clean back in when we went to Murfreesboro. And I got over there and I thought winter was clean until I got over there and saw his competition, and they all looked like somebody just throwed them in the washing machine with about a half a gallon of bleach. And I'm like, how do they do that? Well, the trick is they don't let them get that way in the first place. And winter had been housed next door to a buck, so it happens. We live and learn. If we're not learning, we're probably not living, because that's just part of it. Okay. Is that everybody?
I saw the rabbits, yeah.
Okay, yep. Tag was the last one, the last new addition. Again, we've got two more new additions coming. But if you don't already know, you're not going to know. Unless I might let a little something slip on our Facebook fan page. You never know. Hey, seriously, folks, though. You don't ever like that page. It ain't no big deal. If you do Facebook anyway, I promise everything I post is clean. If it's too boring and you don't want to read it, you don't have to. But we'd like to have you there. You see some pictures a lot of times way before anybody on YouTube is going to see any pictures of anybody. All right. Y'all have a great day. God bless.